The poor wishes to be rich. The sick wishes to be cured. The single wishes to be married. The one who has no children wishes to have children. And all these wishes are valid wishes, halal wishes. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer them. But there are certain people whom their wishes will never be answered. And these are the wishes of the dead. Imagine that we have somebody that actually died and came back and told us what did he see and what does he wish for. Everybody would love to hear that, right? So they can avoid the difficulties and the hardships and the punishment and the torment that this person went through. Say, listen, I've been there. This is what happened to me. Wake up. Don't do this. Do that, right? We would love that because these dead people, their unseen became seen. They have seen angels already. They have seen Jannah and they have seen Nar. So these are the best people to learn from. Rasulullah ﷺ told us what the righteous wish for. When the righteous person is taken to the grave, he would scream and say, قدموني قدموني يالله, bury me, hurry up. And when he is in the grave, he will say, Rabbi, أقم الساعة, Rabbi, أقم الساعة. Ya Allah, make the hour take place. He wants the Qiyamah to rush. And Rasulullah ﷺ told us that one person only wishes to come back to dunya. And that person is Shaheed. Shaheed wishes to come back to dunya and die according to the hadith, في سبيل الله عشر مرات, 10 more times, because of what he saw. What do the other people, may Allah save us, wish for? Some of them wish for to come back above the ground to pray 2 rak'ah. Hadith, we all know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walking and he stopped by a grave. And he said, rak'atan, 2 rak'ah for this person under the grave. أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ بَقِيَّةِ دُنْيَاكُمْ. Ya Allah, if this person was given the opportunity to come back and given a choice, you own Australia, America, Europe, Africa, the whole world is yours, all of it with its gold and silver and diamonds and oceans and mountains, all the streets are named after you, everything is yours. This is one option, and another option, pray 2 rak'ah. Now, I would pick the first. But he, because he saw, he said, 2 rak'ah, 2 rak'ah. Khayrun, not equal, khayrun, better than owning the whole dunya. He saw. Another person saw the ajr of sadaqah. Ya Rab, please, Ya Allah, bring me back ajalin qareeb, just for a little bit. I saw a box at the entrance of the masjid. Bring me back, I want to put a dollar. Ya Allah, I just heard that someone is orphaned. I would like to give him $50. Ya Allah, bring me back fa as-saddaq. I just want to give one sadaqah, Ya Allah, please bring me back. He saw the reward of the sadaqah and its ajr and what it does to the grave. He wants to come back just to give a sadaqah to be saved in the grave. Another person, Allah told us, what do you want to do if I brought you back? You want to build a house? You want to open another business? No, Ya Allah, لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت. I just want to do some righteous things. I just want to maybe read one juz of the Quran. I want to say a few more subhanallah. I want to come to Fajr in Jama'ah. I want to be good to my mother. I want to hug my father and tell him, please forgive me for everything that I have done. Please bring me back, Ya Allah. لعلي أعمل صالح, an open general صالح, any عمل صالح. Ya Allah, please bring me back. And the striking answer comes and says, كلا, كلا, too late. You're not going anywhere. I gave you time after time, year after year. No more coming back. It's done. Anytime you see in the Quran the word Ya Laytani, whatever comes after it will never take place. Ya Waylata, Laytani lam attakhid fulanan khalila. That best friend of yours, if he was not from the righteous people, Allah told us on the day of judgment, you will wish, I will never take him as my khalil, as my best friend. لقد أضلني عن الذكر. He took me away from the masajid. And others would say, يا ليتنا أطعنا الله وأطعنا الرسول. I wish we have obeyed Allah and I wish we have obeyed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I wish I can come back and grow my beard. I wish I can go back and eat with my right hand and do any sunnah I can do. I've neglected the sunnahs. I used to say, it's just the sunnah. يا الله, bring me back. يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا. I wish I followed his path. This is all in the Quran. And the biggest one comes in Surah Al-Fajr. يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي. I wish I've given more to my hayat, to that hayat. I wish I've done more. In this dunya, ya akhwan, Allah in the Quran mentioned it a few times. ما قدمت وأخرت. In our daily life, there are only two options, D and R. There's no end. The day I do not do something that will bring me close to Allah, that means I'm going backward. There's no neutral. Allah did not say قدمت أو أخرت أو بقيت أو لا لا لا. قدمت أو أخرت. So with all the burials that we see every single day, and these are all messages to me and to you, you're next. And we're still delaying tawbah, delaying any amal khair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the people. He said, يسارعون في الخيرات. They race. You're going to visit that brother that's sick. No, I'm going before you. You want to sponsor that? No, no, no. I'm sponsoring him. I already took care of his rent. I'm doing it. يسارعون. They race. They race. Not just they do khairat. They do good. They race to do good. So we are still above the ground, ya akhwan. And we don't want to be from the people who will have these wishes. We want to say, ya Rabb, aqim sa'ah, ya Allah, bring the hour close. That's it. I want to go to Jannah. Ya Allah, we beg you to make our last deeds our best deeds. And our last words, la